दी हमें आजादी के दुनिया हुई हैरान ऐ कायदे आजम।
इन दिस वीडियो आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द लाइफ ऑफ कायदे आजम मोहम्मद अली जिन्ना and how he sacrificed his whole life in the struggle of achieving an independent country named Pakistan. Jinnah's real birth name was Muhammad Ali Jinnah Bhai. He later changed it to simple Muhammad Ali Jinnah or M.A. Jinnah. Qaede Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was born in Karachi on 25th December 1876. His father name was Jinnah Bhai Poonja and his mother name was Mithi Bhai. Jinnah was the eldest of the seven children of Jinnah Bhai Poonja and Mithi Bhai. His family had migrated to Sindh from the Kathiawar area of Gujarat, India. At home, his family talked in Gujarati language, but the family members also knew Kutchi language, Sindhi language and English language, but widely understood although didn't speak in Urdu. Jinnah got married twice. He first got married to Amy Bai before going to London. She was his distant relative. At the time of her marriage, Amy Bai was around 14 or 16 years old. But Amy Bai died shortly after Jinnah had gone to London. At around the same time, his mother also died. In 1918, Jinnah married again. His second wife was Ratan Bai Patel. She was 24 years younger to him. She was the daughter of Jinnah's personal friend Sir Dinsha Patel. Due to his political work, he could not pay attention to his personal life and his marriage also suffered. Finally, the couple separated in 1927. In 1891, Jinnah went to London and worked for a few years for a company. In 1894, Jinnah quit his job to study law. While still in London, he also started to participate in politics. Gradually, Jinnah was developing his own political outlook. He was thinking on the line that India should have a constitutional self-government. Around this time, his father lost his business. This put Jinnah under great difficulty. In the meantime, he had started to practice as a lawyer in Mumbai and he became a successful lawyer. He also built a house in Mumbai Malabar Hill area and this house is also known as Jinnah House. Jinnah had already joined the Indian National Congress in 1906. The Congress was the largest political organization in India. Many members and leaders of the Indian National Congress favored a limited self-government for India. At that time, Jinnah also held the same view. In 1918, Mohandas Gandhi had become one of the main leaders of the Congress party. Gandhi took a line of non-violent protest for gaining self-government for India. Jinnah took a different line. He wanted constitutional struggle to gain the self-government for India. That's why in 1920, Jinnah left the Congress party. He became the president of the Muslim League. At that time, Jinnah brought out a program to reduce the differences between Congress party and Muslim League. The program had 14 points of action. Therefore, it became popular as Jinnah's 14 points. But the Congress party didn't accept these. Around that time, there was a conference of Indian leaders with the government of Great Britain. It is known as the Round Table Conference and it was held in London. Jinnah criticized the policy of Gandhi. The conference failed. Jinnah was also not happy with the Muslim League. He decided to quit politics. Jinnah again started to work as a lawyer in England. During all these days, his sister Fatima Jinnah took care of Jinnah's affairs. She also became a close advisor to him. Many Muslim leaders of India like Aga Khan, Chaudhry Rahmat Ali and Sir Muhammad Iqbal requested Jinnah to come back to India. The leaders of the Muslim League wanted to take charge of the Muslim League. Jinnah agreed to come back to India. His differences with the Congress party continued to become bigger. In 1930, some Muslim leaders like Allama Iqbal had argued for a separate country for Muslims of India. At last, Jinnah came to the conclusion that Hindu and Muslims cannot live in a single country. Jinnah also started to have the idea of a separate country for Muslims of India. Jinnah and Muslim League started to work to get such a separate country. This new country was to be named as Pakistan. He made numberless speeches in which he demanded a separate state for Muslims. It was due to the sincere efforts of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah that the British decided to leave India. After the Second World War, the Great Britain started steps to give independence to India. On 16th May 1946, the British announced plan for a united India. 1 month after, on 16 June 1946, the British announced another plan for the partition of British Raj into two countries, one for the Hindus and one for the Muslims. The Muslim League under Jinnah's leadership accepted the plans. But on 16th August 1946, Jinnah also announced the direct action to achieve independence for Pakistan. After several rounds of discussion, the British Raj was partitioned in August 1947 into two countries, India and Pakistan. Jinnah became the first Governor General of Pakistan. His sister, Fatima Jinnah, became the mother of the nation. Jinnah also became the president of Pakistan's Constituent Assembly. In an address to the Constituent Assembly on 11th August 1947, Jinnah told about the future of Pakistan as a secular state. Jinnah's role in creation of Pakistan as a new nation was very important. This made him very popular among the people of Pakistan. He collected the Muslims on one platform. He created in them spirit of unity. Jinnah fought against Hindus and British. His battle was peaceful. His enemies tried to purchase him, but he remained undaunted. He was a man of great determination. He worked very hard for the nation in spite of his falling health. Jinnah had been suffering from tuberculosis since the early 1940s. Only his sister and very few other persons close to the family knew this. After partition of India and creation of Pakistan, he had become the Governor General of Pakistan. His work was increased, but his health was worsening. To regain his health, he spent many months at his official rest house. Jinnah couldn't regain his health. He died on 11th September 1948 from tuberculosis and lung cancer. In the memory of Jinnah, nations and people have done many things. In Pakistan, he is called Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. His pictures appear on many Pakistani banknotes and coins. Karachi International Airport is named after him. In 1998, a new university in Karachi was named the Muhammad Ali Jinnah University. There are many other places and institutions bearing his name. In many other countries also, some places are named after Jinnah. Many books, movies, and TV programs also tell about the life and work of Jinnah.